I'm gonna take his mask off.
Wow. Hi, I'm Becky from KiwiCo, and I'm so excited for today's video. So if you've ever been to like a theme park or attraction where you've seen robots putting on shows or doing really lifelike activities, those are called animatronics. And I've been a huge fan of animatronics for a while. So today I'm gonna actually try to build my own little one. But to learn more about how they work and what's actually going on inside of there, we're gonna travel all the way back to my hometown of Kansas City, Missouri to interview a real life animatronic specialist who has a whole animatronics warehouse full of awesome and incredible machines. So come on, let's go.
Hey,
hello.
Becky, nice to meet you.
Yes, nice to meet you too.
Welcome to the Animatronics Warehouse.
This is incredible. How did you get into all of this?
Yeah, so when I was 12, I, of course, always was watching YouTube, and one day I found out about animatronics, and I did research, found out about this animatronic show called the Rock-afire Explosion.
Okay.
It was once featured in a chain called Showbiz Pizza Place.
Okay.
And I was just intrigued by the concept, and did even more research, and now, here, after almost 10 years of being interested, about 4 years of this restoration project, it's done, and this is the full Rock-afire Explosion. This is the greatest animatronic band in the world.
I want to see inside these. These look so cool.
Absolutely. So I'll take you back to the workshop.
Hey. So this is what they look like without the fur on?
Yeah, so this is actually on that stage that you see. This is the inside of the gorilla.
Okay.
And the way the animatronics work is actually fairly simple. So all of the movements are powered by air cylinders. And the way an air cylinder works is it's a piston and it's operated by air. So when air comes in through this port, the piston extends.
Oh, so it like pushes it out?
Yes.
Okay.
And then when air comes in through this port, the cylinder retracts.
Now it's just push it the other way.
And that's how every single movement on the character works. So for example, with the eyes, if there was an air cylinder in here right now, the rod would extend and move the eyes, and then it
would that's so cool.
That's how all the movements work. You can see the head tilt, all those cylinders that just
extend
and retract, and the mouth.
So you put all those movements together, and that's how you get the like.
Absolutely.
Okay.
Yeah, and you can see the eyelids are the same way.
Oh, cool. All
right. So that's kind of the bare bones, how everything works, but we're going to actually show you on the stage how those characters actually operate.
If it's air tubes that are making the cylinders push one way or the other, where are all those tubes hidden?
Yeah, so they are all hidden under the stage. That's actually one of the purposes of the stage is to hide the valve bank. And this valve bank is actually what controls all of the individual movements for the character.
That's so fun. So you're just pressing here and the whole head is moving?
Yeah, yeah. So each of those movements just operates with an air cylinder. And as you can see, I'm pressing it with my finger, but this is actually electronic. So there's a computer that sends a signal to this solenoid valve, and that is what creates all the motion for all the characters.
I want to see like what's happening underneath.
Yeah, absolutely. So we will actually come over here and I'm going to take his mask off, and you will be able to see all the internal mechanisms inside him, see how his eyes work.
Wow, that's so cool. I can't help but notice that there's like a ton of extra pistons and joints and like movable parts around the eyes, especially. Like, could you speak more to like why that area requires so much more detail?
I think with the eyes, you're just enabled to do so many different expressive things. Like, for example, I can make him look surprised. I can make him look suspicious. I can do all kinds of things. The eyes are really important in doing that.
That's so cool. Can I try? Like, actually moving him around?
Yeah, absolutely. If you come over here, and this is actually the control board. So this control board right here, this is the latent programming system, and this allows us to program all the new songs and program the movements for the characters. So each one of these buttons, if you press it, it corresponds with a different movement. So this is the mouth, this is the eyelids, and these are the eyes and some of the different head movements. But just pressing each one of those buttons allows you to control individually each of those movements.
So that's how you're getting a lot of these like all of these compound movements where like things are moving together.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah.
Jack, thank you so much for showing us all of this incredible animatronics today. This like totally blew my mind. I had no idea that something so complicated could be so like, honestly, like magical and like full of art and life. I think I'm gonna like try to do something similar with your eyes because I noticed the eyes have so much expression in them. So I'm thinking of actually if I can get away with it using just two hydraulic syringes sets, one for the eyes to move back and forth, and then another for the eyebrows or eyelids to move up and down.
I think that's going to be perfect.
Yeah, hopefully it'll actually be pretty similar to the animatronics you showed us today.
Absolutely, I think so.
Yeah. Can we see the band play before we leave?
Yeah, oh my gosh, yes.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah. All right.
Here we go. Come on, let's go to Louisiana.
So cool. What I learned was Jack's animatronics are actually powered by air. So there's electronics to control the flow of the air, but the actual movement is being caused by compressed air throughout the whole system. So I'm going to use something really similar, hydraulics instead of pneumatics. Both systems work basically like this. You've got a closed system with all this water in it. I push it down here, and the water has nowhere to go but over here, which extends this piston over here. So here's where I'm going to start. My main plan is to have two simple motions that hopefully will be very expressive when put together. One is for the eyes to look side to side, and the other is for the eyelids or eyebrows to go up or down. I think all together it should be able to get a big range of emotions. First off, I need to create some sort of base or structure that I can build everything off of. Let's actually recycle this old crate. Do something like. These are my two eyeballs. And then here's my irises, so I want these guys to. And then I also have some eyebrows that I cut out. But first, actually, I think I want to see what eyelids look like. So like that. Let me try that real quick. So I just traced this, and then I'm going to cut, I think, around here. I'm just going to do that. And ta-da, I now have two eyelids. So I'm gonna use eyelids so that I can get suspicion and surprise. But you could really use anything for this. Like you could use some eyebrows to be like angry, concerned, you know, like doing all sorts of wacky stuff. You could also even use an under eyelid to like really be suspicious. But for today, I'm gonna go with just two eyelids. So this is the amount of distance that my hydraulic system will travel. Alex, come check this out. Did you make this?
Yeah.
That's awesome.
Yeah.
Oh my God. Oh wait, how does it work? So there's two hydraulics back here.
Okay.
So this is the eyes.
And this is connected to this horizontal hydraulic.
Yeah, yeah. Cool. So as I push this one down, it pushes all the water out into this
Very cool.
displaces it. Because the water, since it's all sealed, the water has to go somewhere.
Yep.
So it goes into that tube. And then same thing with this. This is a sealed between this one and this one.
Mm-hmm.
So when I push down here, that one raises up.
That's awesome.
Yeah.
Wow, I love it.
Whoa. This is so good.
Oh, whoa, whoa. Hey, what's over there? What's over there? Wow.
Awesome. Thanks for watching, and if you want to see more videos like this, make sure to subscribe.
See you later.
Bye.